for dinner at 8.
I'm starving.
She loves the theater, but she never comes late.
I never bother with people that I hate. That's why this chick is a tramp.
She doesn't like crap games with barons and earls.
I won't go to Harlem in diamonds and pearls. And I definitely won't dish our dirt with the rest of those girls.
Gregory, what are you doing here at such a late hour?
Tom, I believe someone is after what rightfully belongs to me.
I'm not sure what you mean by that, Gregory.
Well, what I mean is, as you know, Rebecca and I are about to have our 3rd year anniversary, but as of late she's become kind of distant. The reason I say this is because when I came home last night, she seemed off, as if she was hiding something from me.
I see, but what made you feel like she'd be hiding something from you? Would she have any reason to?
Well, you see, Tom, that's not all. Something else seemed off as well. While we were eating dinner, she seemed to always be looking at her phone as if waiting for someone's reply.
So she was texting a friend, perhaps. Why does this bother you?
You see, Tom, when she left the table to go to the restroom, I took a glance at her phone and I saw a name.
A name?
Oh yes, Tom. A name.
Is something the matter, Greg?
Was something the matter? When you slept with my wife?
She never loved you.
How dare you say she never loved me? I did everything for her!
Jennifer.
What are you talking about?
I knew you were having an affair with the librarian. That's why you came home late last night, isn't it?
Doesn't matter what you say, Tom. It's over.